Let's look at the topic 2, that is subsystems of HRM. So we covered the major systems in the previous topic. So we are going to elaborate on that, each subsystems and the system within that, what are the kind of, components, what are the activities has to be performed in each of this particular system part of it. So coming to the first system, what we discussed about is recruitment. When we talk about recruitment, how we try to, probably identify a right kind of an individual for the right kind of a job. For that, the most common kind of method is giving an advertisement in the newspaper or probably any other major media. Nowadays, actually, FM radio also acts as a kind of a major kind of a medium for posting an advertisement for the job. And, when we try to, come out with an advertisement where the job description, job specification has to be, clearly specified. Job description, which talks about what is that job is expected out of it. And job specification is, in order to perform that particular job, what is the requirement from the personal point of view, that is from the employee point of view or a candidate point of view. So look at the recruitment. It's nothing but the process by which a job vacancy is identified and the potential employees are notified about what is the kind of an, opportunities are available. And in order to, probably work out with that kind of an opportunity, what is the kind of a recruitment process has to be worked out and what is this regulated and what are the kind of, employment laws are applicable. So if you look at in India, there are n number of laws are there, right from Wages and Administration Act to, probably the Bonus Act to so many other acts. Laws are applicable. So we need to make sure that all the laws are actually, put in place and the labor laws has to be covered properly and make sure that, every employee has been given a fair kind of a treatment. And main forms of recruitment through an advertisement in newspapers, magazines, trade papers, an internal vacancy list by, probably asking our own employees to refer some of the, new candidates to, probably join for a job. And ultimately, whenever we come out with an advertisement, the job description has to be, clearly mentioned as to what are the result is expected out of this each role. And we need to specify the job specification as to what are the skills and qualities and qualification is required for the particular post. And, based on the suitability and other things, we invite more number of bio data or what you call the curriculum vitae, and through the application form or letter or curriculum vitae, so that we can actually go through it and collect it from different sources. We can scrutinize and shortlist, and based on that we can start with the selection process. So this is the way recruitment happens. Next comes your selections. When we talk about selections, actually we are looking about how do we shortlist, what are the parameters to employ for shortlisting, and how do we conduct an interview. And what are the kind of, pre-interview requisites are look into it, and what are the kind of an exercise or activities has to be conducted for an, selection process. What is the kind of a testing we can do it, whether it is a psychometric testing or an aptitude testing or what is the kind of a testing. So all this thing will be covered under the selection part of it. So under the selection, selection is nothing but it's a kind of a process of assessing the candidates and appointing and, probably the post holder. Applicants shortlisting, has to be properly done based on a correct kind of parameter. We need to look at the job descriptions and job specifications, and accordingly we may have to work out a parameter as to what is the kind of a criteria we can look into it for shortlisting the candidates. And the selection process, it purely depends according to the organizations. Degrees will vary because every organization has got their own culture and their own kind of, methods. So if you look at it, normal common kind of method is your interview method. And interview again, the multiple rounds of interview will be there. Normally the interview will be first held by its kind of, a screening level interview where try to test the employee subject knowledge or a technical knowledge and try to look at it how he can fit into the organization. And the second part of an interview could be an in-depth interview about what is the kind of an skill set he has got by providing some kind of an task, and then we can look at it how we can come out of the best kind of an output. And third level of interview could be on the HR side. HR department can look at it, his attitude and his aptitude, and how is his psychological behavior and other things and all. So these are the ways actually we can conduct an interview. And other common kind of a testing method is your psychometric testing, where they assess this psychometric testing is a very standard kind of a tool which will assess the personality of the applicant, whether he will fit into our job or not. And there will be aptitude testing also will be done. It is basically to assess the skill set of an employee, whether he has got the big picture, whether his conceptual skill is okay or not. And in-tray exercise, there could be an activity can be conducted in and around that particular job and making sure that, you know, this particular person has got a skill set or not. And finally, the presentation, looking for a different skills as well as the idea of the candidate. So these are the ways selection can be done. So we need to work out as a HR department, what is the kind of a selection process can be applicable for what kind of a job. So that has to be, you know, standardized. And third comes your employee legislation. When we talk about employee legislation, during a recruitment and selection, equal opportunity has to be provided right from the recruitment and selection until an employee leaves the organizations. And ultimately, there should not be any kind of a discrimination. Unions, whatever has been formed, has to be recognized by the employer. And contract has to be signed properly, and health and safety environment has to be maintained, and completely, you know, your European Union directives or local, whichever kind of, you know, directives are covered under in India, if you look into it, Indian Labour Organization. So that labour laws has to be, you know, properly followed, and the directives has to be, you know, taken into consideration. Next comes your discipline. When we talk about disciplines, you know, every employee, whenever joins an organization, once he is into the job, and you know, there will be a lot of grievances. We need to work out a procedure as to how the grievance redressal has to be done. There could be a whistleblower policy can be brought in, and we can make sure that, you know, grievances can be handled very effectively. And any dismissal or something like that, it has to be done in more efficient manner and very fair method. It has to be more transparent and open method. And external agencies, like, you know, there will be a lot of arbitration agencies will be involved in India, if you look into it. Again, labor laws has got its own, you know, provisions. There are a lot of labor associations are there, like your NIPM, National Institute of Personnel Management, and in the service industry you have NHRDs, and those kind of people will act as a kind of, you know, mediator between the employee and the employer. And that's the way actually, you know, discipline has to be, you know, carried on very, very effectively. And coming to the you know, discipline, firms or organization cannot just like that sack and workers. There has to be a wide range of procedures and steps has to be followed so that the workplace conflict can be, you know, maintained very well. Informal meeting has to be conducted, and a formal meeting has to be conducted. And if an employee has been found that doing some kind of mistakes, verbal warning has to be given, written warnings has to be given. And if an employee has to be, you know, given in grievance procedures, and whatever kind of a problem he has got, we need to, you know, probably address that particular thing and address these grievances and try to resolve the problem. And working with an external agencies, we need to make sure that discipline has been handled very well. And the next comes your developmental activity of it. When it comes to the developmental activity, we need to provide an equal kind of an opportunity for every employee to, you know, grow in the organization, provide the right kind of a training, provide a promotions and, you know, fair kind of a treatment. And we need to, you know, enhance the skills of every employee by developing the personal, you know, front of the employee, and their goals as well as the organization goal has to be aligned. And continuous kind of a professional development we need to keep working on. And other than that, you know, if you look into it, development is nothing but developing the employee can be regarded as an investing in a value of assets, a source of motivation and source of helping the employee to reach its fullest potential. That's the way we need to look into it. And the training part of it, actually, you know, every time new skills, the employee has to, you know, attain. And time to time, we need to look at it, what is the kind of, you know, demand expected in terms of the skill ability, what is the kind of a gap. We need to identify the training needs, and accordingly, you know, new kind of training, new kind of systems, and we need to keep improve the efficiency so that the overall, you know, individual as well as organizations, you know, learning can happen. And that's the way actually, you know, we need to look into it. And the second thing, if you look into it, if you know the productivity part of it, the trade unions has to be handled very well. The productivity overall, you know, work productivity has to be looked at, but high performing proficiency, or what you call the efficiency, has to be, you know, attained. And time to time, we need to keep rewarding them, motivating them, so that, you know, ultimately employee can reach a right kind of, you know, goal.